So did you ever wonder where that number comes from? We're gonna show you.
Hey guys, it's Dave from MagLab at REI. Let me grab this sleeping bag out of the dryer. Kind of funny, this sleeping bag wasn't even wet when I started. So you might be going, why would you be putting a dry sleeping bag in a dryer? I'll tell you. What I'm gonna do right now, bring it over to Fred, our super cool thermal mannequin. We're gonna test this sleeping bag to tell us how warm it is.
We were testing sleeping bags at REI long before I was even here. This is a 40-something, I can't even remember, year-old mannequin. We think he was born in about 1973. The testing we're doing here is usually development testing, helping to optimize the bag to get it to be the lightest, warmest, most compressible we can for a temperature rating that we're trying to achieve. This is a test that has a lot of meaning to an outdoor customer because this is going to tell you how warm compared to other bags each sleeping bag is that you might want to buy, and so you can get the right one for your trip and your needs.
So, first thing I do before I test the sleeping bag is I throw it in the dryer. That makes sure that the bag's completely dry in case it's humid in the lab. It also makes sure that any clumps in the down are broken up. The insulation is completely lofted, and the sleeping bag is the same every time I run it. We're gonna heat them up to 98 degrees, just like you or me. Then we'll let the freezer take over and tell us how warm this bag is.
He has a hatch inside him. He's filled with water. He has a part, which is a pump, a circulatory system, and a couple of heaters that can bring him up to body temperature, but also simulate metabolism.
You might have noticed Fred's a little bit smaller than you or me. So one thing I'm gonna have to do is make this sleeping bag fit him a little better. All the warmth in your sleeping bag is a big function of the loft of the bag.
We will eventually, once the bag is to the point where we think it's ready to go, send it out to an impartial third-party lab to get a certified test rating, and that's the rating that will hang on the bag in the stores. Usually we are within a degree or so, and we know exactly how our bag is going to test before we have to send it out for that third-party rating.
So when you're camping and you have a bag of potato chips, those are calories you're consuming that your body's gonna burn is energy, which is actually wattage. And that's exactly what Fred's using. So we pump the constant amount of wattage into Fred, just like you or me if I was asleep. And then we're gonna monitor Fred's temperature while we control the temperature of the freezer. And what we're looking for is the temperature where the freezer stays the same and Fred stays the same at that same amount of energy going into him. One thing to remember too with sleeping bags is that they might all be tested the same, but you're all a little different. I know that I sleep a little cold, so if I'm gonna put on a 30 degree bag in 30 degree weather, I'm gonna be cold. So you need to find a bag that works for you. Don't always just trust the number.
What's great about Fred is that he's a wonderful development tool to help our design and development team make the bag that they want to make. With Fred, the designers can quickly try a new idea, test out a design, and find out if it's going to work without having to send bags out or do extensive amount of testing.
It takes about a day to get data with Fred, but since we're here at headquarters, our designers or developers can bring us a bag and we can get it tested the same day. So next time you're shopping for a sleeping bag and you see that temperature rating, you know how we got it. Nighty night, Fred.